Hello, Vinyl Community. This is Randall back today with another video. Today, I'm going to show you some records that I've picked up in the first part of February. So, I picked up this Blue Note 80 release. I picked this up at the record store at Grimey's. Got this a little while back. I think I meant to show it in a previous video and I forgot about it, but this is Una Mas, One More Time. It's Kenny Dorham, trumpet player from the late 50s, early 60s. This album, I guess, has a little bit of a Latin feel to it. This is actually what we're hearing right now in the background. It says Joe Henderson on tenor sax. Herbie Hancock on piano. Butch Warren playing bass, and Anthony Williams is the drummer. So, yeah, this is pretty much exactly what I would expect. There's only three songs on here. The first side is Una Mas, takes up the whole side. You can hear what it sounds like. They just sort of work into this cool groove, you know, and just kind of let it go on for a whole side. So, yeah, very pleasant. The second side just has two songs on it, Straight Ahead and Sao Paulo. So, just good early 60s hard bop, I guess, is what the category this would fall into. I got another one of these Blue Note 80 releases. This is Freddie Hubbard, Open Sesame. Picked this one up just a couple days ago, actually at Grimey's again, also. This one, the cool thing about this one is it has Tina Brooks playing tenor sax on it, so... Tina Brooks, I know, has just had a Blue Note Tone Poet Series record release, but I didn't get that one. I do have his first album on Blue Note, so I'm a big Tina Brooks fan. So, this one sounds good. This is, I think this is Freddie Hubbard's first album as a leader for Blue Note. So, he's playing with Coy Tyner on piano, Sam Jones on bass, and Clifford Jarvis on drums. Sort of a new name to me, so this is very good. Starts out with Open Sesame. It's a fantastic version of But Beautiful on here. It's a song that I know by Billie Holiday, a song that usually has words, but there's an instrumental version here. Really nice. He just basically plays the melody straight through. All or Nothing at All, One Mint Julep on here. So some jazz standards, along with a couple of originals, Hub's Nub and Open Sesame, which is actually written by Tina Brooks. So, very good album. Once again, kind of like the Kenny Dorham album, you know, you pretty much know what you're going to get with these early 60s Blue Note recordings. So it always sounds good. Really excellent. I'm enjoying that one. This is on the regular Blue Note label. I got another jazz record. I actually sent off for this one in the mail. This is Sarah Vaughan, After Hours with Sarah Vaughan. This is a good record. This is her singing with an entire orchestra, with a big band. I actually ordered the wrong record. She has another record that is called, After Hours with Sarah Vaughan. It may be listed as being a record by Sarah Vaughan, Mundell Lowe, and George DeVivier. That's one that Black Beans and Rice reviewed a while back. At least 6 months ago. I'm sure it's been a while since he reviewed it, but it sounded really, he made it sound really good, particularly because she's just singing with that small combo, Mundell Lowe playing guitar and George DeVivier on bass. And that's the one that I'm really hoping to get, so I'm still on the lookout for this one. This one's good. For that one, I'm looking on the lookout for this one. I have this one. Sounds good. There are some fantastic songs on here: "Street of Dreams," "Summertime." And so I will listen to this one a lot. I mean, I love Sarah Vaughan. But yeah, just unfortunately, it wasn't the one that I was looking for. This is a reissue. Comes on this Columbia label. This is a 2017 reissue. On Impex. I think it was Impex. No, sorry, this is just Sony Music Entertainment. I got another record that day when I set off at that Sarah Vaughan. Actually, this was the one I was looking for in the first place. I found this one on Elusive Disc, along with that Sarah Vaughan. I got this one because I saw Mazzy talking about this one just a few weeks ago, and then it had been shown by a few people, you know, within the past few months. So this is sort of a jazz standard record that a lot of people have, and everything I've heard about it's been really good. I got a this is Michel Legrand. The name of the album is Legrand Jazz, and he's playing with a bunch of Blue Note All Stars on here. So I was glad to get this one. I had another Michel Legrand album they made with Bud Shank. And so that one sounded really good. So that one featured just Bud Shank for the most part. This one has an all-star lineup on it. So Miles Davis is the big one on here. But yeah, Herbie Mann is on here. John Coltrane, Phil Woods, just a whole lot of stars. So this is really cool. Gatefold sleeve. This is a really good pressing. It tells me that it's mastered by Chris Bellman and Bob Donnelly on Bernie Grumman Mastering All Tube Cutting System in Hollywood. Analog mixdown transfer of the original 1958 work tapes. So, yeah, sounds really excellent. This has some jazz standards on it. Jitterbug Waltz, Night in Tunisia, Stomping at the Savoy, Round Midnight. Don't get around much anymore. Fantastic record. So Legrand is basically an arranger and conductor, I think, for these, for this big band that was put together for this record. This one is, yeah, this is the one that was on Impex Records, so I'm not sure who Impex is, but it's a really high quality record. Sounds fantastic. I got this Lee Konitz record. I got this at Grimey's a few weeks ago. Lee Konitz, Inside Hi-Fi. This is a late 50s recording on Atlantic Records. This is a reissue on Pure Pleasure. This record is excellent. I'm a really big Lee Konitz fan. He is an alto saxophonist. He's born in 1927. He is still playing today at 93 years of age. He was part of the bop era. He played on Miles Davis' Birth of the Cool sessions. Played with a lot of people throughout the 50s. And like I say, he's still playing today. This one, I got another album a couple weeks ago where he was playing with Brad Meldow. I mentioned on that record that one took me a few listens to really get used to. That was really kind of some difficult listening, even though it now has become one of my favorite records. And really, one reason I've really been able to get into that even more is from listening to this one, in which he just plays the song sort of straight through. He plays the melody. It's much easier to listen to. But also gave me some guidance in how to listen to his music. So I've also got some Lee Konitz from In Between, a CD that he put out in the early 90s, and also some work with, I think it's like the Bad Plus. There's a small jazz combo up there in New York. So this record's really good. There's a problem with this record. The first two songs in this record have like these digital glitches in them. So I went to their webpage and Pure Pleasure Records, and they tell me it's newly remastered, but it doesn't tell me what it's remastered from or who did the remastering. Most of the album sounds great, so I don't want to take it back to the record store, but I did write an email to the record company telling them about the problem with the first two songs. It just sounds like a glitch type noise, just like a beeping type noise. Happens about maybe 15 times in the first song and maybe 10 times in the second song. After that, the rest of the record's fine, and it really sounds excellent. It's dead quiet and really good. So I haven't heard back from Pure Pleasure Records yet, but I hope that they will respond by telling me they're going to send me a replacement record. We'll see what happens with that. If they don't replace it, this is still okay. I mean, those first two songs, it's irritating about that beeping, but the rest of it sounds fine. And I guess I can sort of get past that. Those digital glitches, whatever they are. This is on a, I've really never seen that label before. This is a very basic Atlantic label. So,
yeah, Lee Konitz.
You'd probably be interested to know who he's playing with on this. He actually is playing with two different combos. So on the first side, he's playing with a guitarist who is named Billy Bauer. On the second side, there's a pianist named Sal Mosca. So there's a bass player on both sides, and there's a drummer on both sides. Dick Scott on side two is the drummer, and Arnold Fishkin. Dick Scott's a drummer on both sides. Arnold Fishkin's the bass player for side one, and Peter End is the bassist for side two. Another interesting thing about this one is that Lee Konitz plays tenor sax on side two. It talks about that in here, and he discussed that with the producer of the record, and he decided to give that a try, so it sounds good. I really enjoy all this, except for the problem with the noise, so I hope I'll get that fixed. I heard something about a sale going on at Barnes & Noble, so I wasn't really even aware of one around here, but I did finally locate one in just north of Nashville. About 20 minute drive up there. I went up there. There weren't really too many records. They were having the half price sale, but there just wasn't much to choose from there. But I did find this Flaming Lips record. I don't really know how you say the name of it. It's OCZYMLODY, Oxymlody. I think this is from 2017, and it sounds like Flaming Lips. I've only listened to this a few times. It sounds good. It's kind of hard for me to understand the words. It has this inner sleeve with the words on it. But boy, those words are really hard to read. You can see it's red on purple. So I'm going to have to give this record a little bit more attention. Very cool inner sleeve. But I'm a big Flaming Lips fan. And I feel sure I'm going to end up liking this record quite a lot. Good that you'd like all their records, so yeah, I'll be giving that a few more listens. Flaming Lips. Another one I got up there at that sale at Barnes & Noble's with the Electric Prunes. I had too much to dream last night. This is a psych album from the 60s. Gets shown frequently in the vinyl community. But I'd never had it before, so of course I knew the song. I have that compilation, you know, the Nuggets compilation with I Had Too Much to Dream last night. And the rest of it sounds good. My only problem with this record, as with, you know, so many of these 60s psych records, is it has the novelty tune. You know, Toonerville Trolley, last song on this album. A lot of these psych albums have that. So, you know, people refer to them as like the vaudeville sound or just like a novelty type sound. And I would prefer to just have a shorter side rather than end up with that novelty type song. You know, not all of the psych albums from the 60s have that. I think some of the better ones, the ones that really go deeper into psych, don't have those novelty type songs. I think these are the ones that run the major labels, and I really don't know what the reasoning was behind that, but that's my only problem with that record. Mostly it sounds great. It is on this cool purple vinyl. That's the cool Reprise label. It's mono. Yeah, it's a mono copy too. So, that was really good. Then the most recent record I got is this Tame Impala record, which came out on Friday. I got the two albums prior to this. So I wanted to get this one too to keep up with what this guy's doing. Tame Impala is really just one guy from Australia who records it all himself, and then I guess when he goes on tour, he hires a band to go with him. So, I've listened to this a few times, and it sounds very much like a continuation of the previous two albums. So, I'm going to continue to listen to this. The guy on Cass on that YouTube channel for the record store in Monterey, Cass and Lorraine, is that her name? Cass gave it a really good review, so I would refer you to that if you want really more detail about this record, because I haven't listened to it enough yet to really know, other than to say that it's no surprise from what I heard on the previous two albums. So comes with this poster, which is basically just the same as the gatefold sleeve. And comes with these cool inner sleeves. Blue vinyl on that one, and red vinyl for this one. So, yeah, there you go. So those are the records I've gotten in the first part of February. So, yeah, let me know what you think about those records. Have you heard any of these records, or you know, do you want to hear them? And, yeah, that's it. Thanks very much for watching.